Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, I'll show you a very easy trick to make old footage look better by simply doing a super easy sky replacement trick. And you can do that in DaVinci Resolve. Either you can do this in the free version or the studio version or the iPad version. It should be available in all versions. And we use this trick a lot on the upcoming short film we did, The Killer Snails, because that was done on some very old material and it looked pretty washed and blown out, so we kind of had to do that. And there is a little trick to that as well, but that will be right in the tutorial. Again, if you are interested in watching the short film, it will premiere on the 1st of December this year. If you see this video after, there will be a link up in the top corner right here to the video. Yeah, that's more or less it. So let's jump right into this pretty fast little tutorial about how to do sky replacements. Let's go. Okay, so let's get started. So here we are in DaVinci Resolve and we have this clip and we're going to enhance this and make it look a lot better. First thing we're going to do is to push Alt and then just drag the clip because we will need a copy of that later. And I'm just going to push D on the keyboard to deselect it. So now we'll just jump right into DaVinci Resolve's color page. And in the color page, you can see I did a little grade on it. It's nothing special, just a tad. And we are going to make this look a lot better by actually just adding in some clouds and do a super easy sky replacement using the Neural Engine in DaVinci Resolve. And I'm just going to search here and I'm just going to type in sky. Like that. I'll have my sky replacement. I'm just going to add that in here. And by the way, the sky replacement tool will work in the free version. At least it's working on my iPad version, the free one. So I'm sure it will be in the free version as well. So let's just go into the sky replacement tool. And the first thing we need to do is we're going to use a qualifier. And I'm going to change this into a 3D qualifier. And then I'm just going to kind of select this area here. So again, this is old footage, so it can be a little hard to make it look good, but we are going to give it a go here. So I'm going to go into the despill and I'm going to turn that up quite a bit. I'm going to zoom in here. Also, I will maybe want to add in a little more here. So I'm just going to go here and select the plus. I'm going to plus this in as well, like that. Also, since I am on the plus, I'm going to take this part here as well, something like that. And then I need to clean up this here. So I can go on to the minus and I can try to see if we can minus this part here as well. And then we could clean it up by going into the clean black and the clean white and try to clean it up as good as possible. So we'll go into the sky replacement tool here and I'll go into the artificial sky and I'm just going to preview artificial sky. I'm going to tickle this off here and then I'm just going to turn it up a little bit and I'm going to toggle it off again. So here we have like artificial sky like that. And we can also put in some clouds and we can do that by just turning this up here. Like you see right here. And we can scale the clouds if we want it to be different. We can also change the shape of the clouds if we want that to be. And in basically we can do a lot of things here. But we're actually going to see if we can clean it up a little bit more. So I'll go into the clean white here. I'm going to toggle that a bit. And then I'll go into the clean black. And also the black clip, I can change that a little bit here. And also the white clip. I'm going to do that, something like that. And then we can play around with the despill. And again, we go into the clean white. We're trying to make this white border disappear. And And of course, we can do a lot of other things to make it way better. But of course, you can see right now we have a problem. And that is the door here. It has kind of a problem. So we're doing the best we can to clean this up. As you see, it is old footage. It's a bit hard. However, now the door is really destroyed. So what I want to do here is actually... thing is, I want to add this in at this point as well. So we have this reflection of the outside. And again, we can finesse this as much as we want and go into the despill, and we can take the despill down a bit, all the way down, something like that. But now the door looks strange. The way we are going to fix that is to go back to the edit page, and I'm just going to push D for selecting this first clip, and then I'll just go back to the color page again. And on the clip, going to the beginning, I'm going to zoom in, and I'm going to change this by taking a mask, and I'm just going to take the curves tool. And again, we can do this super precise, but for the sake of the length of this tutorial, I'm just going to do it very quickly. I'm just going to do a little mask here on the door, like that. And then I'll go into the tracker, and I'm just going to track this forward and backwards. And hopefully it will track well. It didn't track very well. It tracked pretty bad because of the movement. So we're going to do this in a different way. I'm just going to reset my tracking, and I'm just going to put this to frame, and I'm going to hit the keyframe because we are just going to do this, track this super manual. So we just go here, and we want this to be around here. And we want it to be here. And we're again going a little bit forward, and then we are just going to move our mask, making it fit. I'm doing this very fast for the sake of the length of this tutorial. So it's just to give you a basic idea of how to do this. And of course, we could soften our mask as well, if that's necessary. Again, just to give you the idea here. So I'll just go to the last frame. It needs to be around here, I guess. So we have the tracked version right here. And for the sake of this tutorial, I think that is good enough. So I'm just going to take this off, and I'm going out here to the grid, right click, and I'm going to add in an alpha mask, and I'm going to connect that to the blue output. And here we have that. And basically, that is how we did the shot for the short film. And if you want to see the short film, if it's after the 1st of December this year, you can just find it up here in the top corner. Otherwise, it will premiere here on YouTube on the 1st of December. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.